Good morning students, welcome back. Today we are going to start part number 2, that is lecture number 2 of chapter 2, that is environmental pollution. In last lecture we have studied about water pollution, how it gets polluted, what is its harmful effects and solution to reduce the water pollution. In today's lecture we will talk about air and water pollution. So let us start. First I will read the paragraph and then explain you about the same. Just like water, air pollution has become a major concern of the world. Industries have developed in every city and in most of the villages. The smoke and gases emitted by the industries mix with air and cause air pollution. Today, the use of mineral oils has increased tremendously. The vehicles running on fossil fuels like petrol and diesel emit smoke and harmful gases like hydrocarbons, nitrogen oxides, carbon monoxide, and carbon dioxide, which merge with the air, and their proportion in air has increased. The proportion of carbon dioxide has increased due to the cutting of trees, which has led to the intense problem of global warming. Deforestation is another reason behind the increase in air pollution. Dust particles float in the air due to the depletion of forest cover and trees. Students, in today's world, numerous industries have developed in every cities and in most of the villages. The smoke and gases which are emitted by these industries get mixed with the fresh air of the atmosphere and pollutes it. Not only this, students, in today's world, the use of mineral oils has also increased, and for this, the vehicle running with these fuels, that is petrol and diesel, also emits harmful gases like nitrogen oxides, carbon monoxide, and carbon dioxide, which merge with the air and pollutes it. Moreover, the proportion of carbon dioxide in air has increased due to the cutting of trees, and which in turn has led to the intense global warming. Hope you have understood how air pollution is caused. Now let us see what is the effect of air pollution on the life of human beings. Air pollution causes various diseases such as asthma, breathing problems, lung infection, etc. Dust particles floating in the air lead to diseases like cold, cough, and allergy. There have been instances when animals died due to suffocation caused by the excess of pollution. The temperature of the atmosphere has increased due to pollution. At times, these poisonous gases mix with raindrops and cause acid rain, which is very harmful for animals and vegetation. Students, as written in the paragraph, air pollution leads to the diseases like asthma, breathing problems, lung infections, etc. The dust particles that are floating in the air causes cold, cough, and allergy. And not only this, students, the poisonous gases which are present in the air mixes with the rainwater and causes acid rains, which is very harmful for vegetations and human beings also, and the animals. Now, let us see how we can prevent air pollution. To prevent air pollution, it is necessary to make certain rules for the industries and implement them strictly. Equipments that can filter smoke and harmful gases should be developed and installed. Industries that do not follow the norms should be punished strictly by heavy fine or should be shut down. Students, government should implement strict rules for the industries, and also industries should plant or build in some equipments which can filter the smokes before it releases in the air. And government should follow the strict rule that those industries which are not following the rules and regulations should pay the heavy fine, or government shut those industries. Environment awareness campaign should be organized. These environment awareness campaigns should be organized in different colleges, schools. It must be published different environment related awareness programs related books must get published in the colleges so that students are aware of it. We as a citizen of India should use petrol and diesel in judicious manner. Use of pollution free instead of petrol and diesel, students, we must use the fuels like CNG and LPG, which are pollution free, so that we can reduce air pollution to some extent. Not only this, students, also government must implement the POC rule. POC rules are there for vehicles. Those vehicles which are emitting too much of gases, that vehicle should not be permitted on the road. So this we can do to prevent air pollution. Students, now let us see the third pollution, that is land pollution. Land pollution is not something that is easily visible, but in this developing world, land pollution has become evident on large scale. Growing industries and the polluted water from the drains flow on the ground and slowly pollute the land. The people who run industries and factories always try to acquire more land than what they require. According to them, they acquire more land for their future development. When industries occupy the agricultural land, it surely pollutes it, as the industries dump solid waste on land. Nowadays, polythene, that is plastics, is used on a large scale. Plastic is non-biodegradable substance and pollutes the land. The urban waste like plastic, scrap and chemical dumped on lands gets dispersed over farmlands by wind and thus pollutes the land. Farmers use chemical fertilizers extensively to increase production, and it also plays a major role in polluting the land and water. Students, as written in the paragraph, the industries which are far away from the riverside, now what they do to dump their waste? They dump their waste material and chemically infested water on the land, which slowly and gradually pollutes it. What they do when an industry people wants to acquire a land for opening their industry, to build their plant, they take more than the required land so that they can easily dump their waste material or chemically infested water on the land, which in turn pollutes the land which are adjacent to the industries. Moreover, the plastic bags which are used by us, which we throw in our day-to-day life, gets mixed with the soil but do not decompose, which eventually kills the microorganisms which are helpful for fertility of soil. Not only this, students, the fertilizers which are used by the farmers for their healthy crop productions also plays a major role in polluting the land. Students, now let us see what are the harmful effects of land pollution. Polluted water from industries and drainage is used in the irrigation of fertile land, resulting in the polluted production of grains, vegetables, etc. Cultivated on such land, it results into tuberculosis and bone diseases. Exhausted or shrinking fertile land leads to the risk of scarcity of crops. Plastic, solid waste material from the industries and polluted water destroy microorganisms which make land fertile. Eventually, land becomes barren due to the destruction of microorganisms. Students, now when the farmers use the polluted water or the chemically infested water for their production, for their crop production, and that crop production, if we are eating in our day-to-day life, it leads to the tuberculosis and bone diseases. And lastly, as I have explained before, the polluted water and the waste material from the industries mixes with the soil and kills the microorganisms which makes the land fertile. And what happens due to that? Eventually, the land becomes barren. And due to that, there is less production of crops. Now let us see how we can prevent land pollution. Land pollution can be controlled. We should use plastic and necessary chemicals judiciously. No industries should be set up on arable land. We should conserve environment. Use of organic and traditional manure instead of chemical fertilizers is advisable. Pesticides should be used in minimum possible proportion. The plastic and solid waste should be recycled. Use of conventional sources of energy and green technology should be introduced. Drip irrigation saves water and prevents land degradation. Students, how we can control? We can use the plastics which do not get mixed with the soil easily. We must use them in judicious manner. Also, government should not permit any industries to the land which are near to the farms, because there is a risk of polluting the farmlands also. Farmers should use the organic and traditional manures like cow dung and all that purpose for their crop production and not the chemical fertilizers, so that the fertility of land is maintained. Also, the farmers should use less pesticides for their crop productions. We as a citizen must try to use non-conventional sources of energy like solar panel and all that in our houses. Also, we must apply the drip irrigation process in our farmers, sorry, not we, we must, farmers must apply the drip irrigation system in their farmlands, which can prevent water from the wastage and we can prevent land degradation. So this was all for today's lecture, students. Hope you have understood the two pollutions, that is air pollution and land pollution. But if you are having any problems, if you have not understood any word, any particular word which you need to understand properly, you can tell me in comment box or you can personally send me the message so that I can help you out. We will meet with the next pollution, that is noise pollution, in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.